Rebecca Benes Sports Chat.
503.
All right, here again from beautiful Bo's backyard. Not your chicken and western biscuit place, but actually beautiful Southeast Portland backyard.
It's beautiful. Okay,
let's do this thing quickly, Bo. We had a bye week.
We did.
We loved the bye week.
Yeah.
And we've got some stuff to talk about. We're going to do Pac-12, college football, NFL. And then I got the Peyton Manning question.
Good.
Like, how good is Peyton Manning good. In history thing?
Yeah, that'll be
Peyton
nice.
Peyton did that last night. Boom. You're up, Bo. What do you think about this thing?
Well, college football, Pac-12.
Yeah, yeah.
We had a bunch of blowouts. Washington went big. Let's see who else. UCLA went big. Wazoo went big. Leach put in his defensive lineman, his first stringers, at the end of the game in the fourth quarter just to keep the shutout against Idaho. I thought that was a little bogus. But then we had some really good games.
Stanford,
Arizona State. Stanford was actually up big at half, but Arizona State came back. Kelly for Arizona State had a couple picks, which probably could have.
Does this show how good Stanford is, though?
Are we still waiting for? No, I think it does because Arizona State's got a pretty good offense, and Stanford was able to withstand the second half barrage. So I think it does. I think it legitimizes Stanford some. They should get some more respect. The USC game, USC Utah State, 17-14. USC was 3-14 on third downs, only had 282 yards a whole game, lots of penalties. So that was surprising, yeah. But I'm starting to get to that phase where maybe I'm expecting too much out of SC. Maybe, I mean, like, I don't know. It's been like three or four games now where it's like, that's not USC football, man.
No, and I think the thing with USC is that they don't know where they're at. I think the sanctions are now starting to really feel a pinch. Yeah. I think they didn't really understand who they had when they had the freshman quarterback. They lose Barkley. They had nobody to fill Barkley's shoes.
Yeah.
Now you got freshmen. You don't really know what you're going to do with these guys, even if they're redshirt.
Yeah.
You still have some of the best talent down there, but we've seen this before with SC. You can have good talent down there. Before Pete Carroll, there was talent down there. Didn't mean that they were going to win championships.
True.
So I think that way you look at it is SC still has an opportunity in the South. The South is a gimme conference at this point. If you can be good in the South, then you can win it. You still got to deal with Oregon. You still got to deal with Stanford. You still got to deal with Oregon State or Washington or
UCLA.
I mean, there's a tremendous amount of teams in this conference that can come up and get you.
Yeah.
I don't even think they're close right now.
Yeah.
I think if you give SC a year or two, you give them the scholarships back, you get this Reggie Bush thing out of the way and let them go head-to-head against these guys, they'll go right back to where they need to be, which is the best team in the South.
And, you know, it's beneficial for the Pac-12 to have them be strong. So I'm all for them getting back to being a solid franchise, solid program.
But also the 10 years that SC wasn't good in the 90s, you give a chance for every single Pac-12 team to be the Pac-12 champion.
Yeah.
You know, so if you take a decade off, and what was 2005 was the championship game.
Yeah, with Texas.
So, yeah. So, you know, you give yourself a decade off from there. Everybody else is going to get theirs.
Yep.
That means 2015, 2 years, they'll be right back to where they need to be.
Yeah.
You know.
Another few games, we had Oregon State over San Diego State on a last-minute pick six by Oregon State.
What the hell?
34-30.
Was that?
Did
you get to watch it?
I didn't, no. I
got to watch the entire second half.
Nice. Dude, Oregon State was down 27-14 in the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
That's crazy, man.
Yeah, yeah, it was a situation where – you know, again, the Beavs' defense is their weakness.
Yeah.
Their offense is good.
Yeah.
But it's so one-dimensional.
It is. They had 10 rushing yards the whole game.
Dude, I don't care if Mannion is the greatest quarterback ever.
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to be that good without having balance.
Yeah,
I agree. Stanford will eat them up. Oregon will eat them up. UCLA will chew them up the way UCLA looks right now.
Yeah.
I don't think the Beavs beat Washington. I don't think the Beavs – I mean, and going into this season, I thought the Beavs could have a good little run. They had some guys coming back. They had skill guys. They had guys on defense who you knew their name. You had some other guys coming back. But their defense is just – I don't know what the hell's going on wrong there.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's scheme or if it's the players or what.
Yeah, I don't know either, man. But, again, another team I'd like to see pick it back up because they're starting to slip a little.
Well, I could see Wazoo beating them this year.
Yeah.
Big time.
Yeah, because, I mean, yeah, you get a passing team like that and you can't defend.
No.
It could get ugly. We also have Utah beating BYU by 7.
That's a huge game.
It is.
Every year, that's one of the biggest games on the whole calendar.
It is.
Holy War.
Yeah, and I love that name.
Oh, yeah.
And Utah was 1-14 on third downs, which is atrocious, which is partly why I was kind of surprised that they were able to hold on and win this game.
But they were able to not have that quarterback run.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was the secret. That Hill.
Mm-hmm.
That guy.
Yeah.
He had like 250 yards against Texas.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
Rushing yards.
Yeah.
So, yep. I mean, the guy can run. Obviously, Texas isn't what they usually are. But the thing is that Utah is better than we thought they were going to be. Mm-hmm. Colorado might be improved. The Beavs have Colorado this week. Can we talk about this week?
Yeah, definitely. Up? Yeah, man. We got Colorado at Oregon State.
Beavs, Colorado is going to be a hell of a game.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to be a hell of a game because Colorado's on their way up. And the Beavs look like they're on their way down.
Yeah.
And that's a situation where if the Beavs know what they're doing, they better come out and just kick ass.
Yeah. I agree.
Absolutely,
man.
Destroy. At home, you got to get that done.
Yeah, and coming up this week, we also have Arizona at Washington. So I think that'll be nice because Washington hasn't really been tested since the Boise. Well, they haven't played a very good team since they played Boise State.
And Arizona, you should see them getting better this year.
I agree. Rich Rod out there. Yeah, I agree. Stanford at Washington State.
Again, tough place to play.
Yeah.
Stanford. Going up there, they can throw the ball over the place.
Yeah, and I think the big key to the game there is obviously Stanford's line play, running the ball, time control. Yeah.
They just dominate.
Yeah, if you don't, what you do with a team, big throwing team, is you keep them off the field. And
but you know what? Washington State went down to SC and beat SC in the Coliseum, trying to run all over them.
SC was.
SC was not trying to throw the ball over the place because their quarterback was garbage at that point.
Yeah.
So they were trying to run the ball, and they couldn't.
Yeah.
So Wazoo could be better in the up front.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and then we got Cal.
Cal.
So the Cal game, I'm thinking right now, Cal is the worst team in the North. Am I right in thinking that Cal or Oregon State?
Yeah, I was going to say, I would say Cal, but Oregon State's giving them a run for their money.
Okay, so if Oregon State Cal is this weekend, who do you think wins?
I think Cal, because Cal's got a good passing. They have the second highest-rated passing offense.
What about their rushing yardage? Are they kind of like the Beavs, where they can't run the ball?
Yes, yeah. So they have Bigelow as their main running back, and he's he doesn't get very many carries at all. I think he's only got a few hundred yards this season.
And the freshman is a true freshman quarterback.
Yeah, Goff.
Coming into Autzen.
Yep.
Okay, we said that same thing about the kid from Stanford, but,
you
know, Cal's always scary, always got to respect Cal. Cal and Oregon used to be very similar programs. We've obviously taken a step up, but Cal is always scary. I don't give a damn. Playing at night, 7:30 start. I see Oregon blowing them out. I see 52-14, whatever that is going to be.
Yeah.
But Cal's always interesting.
Yeah, and they've got Harper and Treggs as their two big wide receivers. And I don't know, there's just been a thing with Oregon going up against talented wide receivers. And I know the Goff kid's a freshman, so he's not exactly like Barkley throwing to Lee and Woods on the outside. But something scares me when somebody comes in with a couple pretty decent wide receivers. So,
yeah.
But at the same time, I expect Oregon to get several turnovers. Goff's already got four picks on the season against him.
We'll get some picks.
Yeah, I'm looking for some more picks. The other game for Pac-12 this week is SC at Arizona State.
Could be a good game. ASU.
I see ASU winning.
That's in Tempe.
In Tempe.
Yeah, I would say ASU. Yeah. I would say ASU.
I mean, and so that's another loss to SC.
0-2 in the Pac-12 for SC to start the year.
Yeah.
When was the last time that would have happened?
Yeah, geez, man.
I mean, that's crazy.
Yeah, so it's exciting.
Now, I do see SC somehow rebounding and putting together a somewhat decent year at the end of the year.
Yeah.
I see them even challenging you at UCLA in that last game.
Yeah, I see them knocking off teams that we assume that would beat them, like a UCLA or I don't know, like strange things have happened. I could even see them somehow beating a Stanford on a, you know, hey, you wake up one day and read the news and Stanford lost to SC. You wouldn't be that shocked. Like, it would be an upset, but it's not unthinkable.
No.
So, yeah, I wouldn't sleep on SC in terms of
– at all.
And so I'm actually kind of – they're a little spooky this year. I'm glad we're not playing them during the regular.
Big time.
Because that could be a game.
Well, it's a letdown. It's a no-win situation.
Yeah, totally.
What else we got for the college football?
Nationally, a lot of blowouts again. Ohio State blowing out people. Louisville, Florida State blowing out people. A&M.
But the Georgia game was close.
Yeah, the Georgia game was close. Let's see. Yeah, we had Georgia and North Texas. It was tied up 21 apiece in the third quarter.
I watched the second half of that one.
Crazy. And Murray had a pretty good game, too. He had 408 yards, yeah, no, three touchdowns.
Georgia wasn't playing bad.
Yeah.
No, they were. They weren't dominating.
Yeah. You had the Michigan UConn game. I don't think this quarterback Gardner from Michigan is going to cut it. 13 for 25, 111 yards, two picks.
That's a wide receiver.
Yeah, coming in playing. I mean, and I understand.
Can't Michigan get a quarterback?
I know, it's crazy.
Tom Brady didn't even start there.
I know, but I don't know. You're stuck with him. You're stuck with him now. So good luck the rest of the season. But that shows you a little bit about what's happening in the Big Ten. Notre Dame barely gets by Michigan State, but. Still, and Nebraska loses last
week. Ohio State's going to beat the hell out of them.
Yeah, Ohio State's going to run that conference. So
Ohio State loses their quarterback,
yeah.
And the other quarterback comes in and throws like six touchdowns or something.
Yeah,
like.
In the first half.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I know that they were playing a team and they blew them out by 70. But.
Yeah. Bama, Colorado State. That was kind of interesting only because Bama was 2 for 10 on third downs. Only had 66 rushing yards, and it was 17-6 in the fourth quarter.
We can get Bama, I think.
So that's showing me.
I think we can get
him. Yeah, it's showing me some cracks, man. What else was good? I don't know. Let's see. We did.
It was a weak weekend.
Yeah, Miami blew out Savannah State. Florida, Tennessee, 31-17. Florida lost their quarterback Driscoll. He's gone for the year with a broken leg. So there goes.
But you know what? Their offense wasn't any good anyway. So let that other kid play, and who cares?
That's true, and they still
remember
have
the year they had the senior, and they had Tebow. Both those quarterbacks.
Yeah,
sucked.
Was that Leak?
Leak.
Yeah.
And they won like a title with them. So
yeah, that's
they
right.
Both sucked. Who cares?
Yeah. So yeah, man, there really wasn't. It wasn't a great weekend. I think I heard somebody call it cupcake.
Yeah,
cupcake Saturday or something.
But what happens next week? Is there any good games next week?
Yeah, next week there's some good games. We got Ole Miss and Bama. We got Wisconsin at Ohio State. Like
that
I said,
that should be a good test.
Yeah, it should be a good test because you know the Ohio State's played Cal, they played some other teams, but and then we also have LSU Georgia. I think LSU could fall, even though Georgia's already got the loss to South Carolina.
There again, that goes to your theory of the SEC. It's hard to go through that thing.
It is.
And
if
get picked off
yeah,
one
and
of these weekends.
LSU gets dropped, that means you only have Bama as the undefeated in the SEC.
Right.
And you have Florida without a starting quarterback.
Yep.
And you have South Carolina not being as dominant as people thought. So so that's basically the
and
big
Oklahoma.
Games this weekend. Yeah, Oklahoma, Notre Dame. I'm really.
I know, but it's still a good game.
It is, yeah. And
Oklahoma
know.
Should crush.
They should. And
after getting beat last year, you would know they're hungry.
Yeah, and see, that's the thing. I would think that Oklahoma would be chomping at the bit to separate themselves and the Big 12 from the Big 10 or some of these other conferences, the ACC or the All-American Conference and that they got Louisville in now. But you don't really see them. I mean, Texas has fallen off the map. They're talking about Saban. Texas asked to talk to Saban's agent about coming to Texas. And it's like, dude, why would you? Nah, that's not going to happen.
Nope.
But, so college football, man, it's.
We're doing pretty well.
Yeah, it's exciting.
Now what about
right
NFL?
Now.
Let's do this NFL thing.
Yeah, NFL. I was really disappointed by the Eagles on Thursday. I was shocked at how undisciplined professional football players looked out there.
Well, first of all, I think the Chiefs are better than people were giving them credit for.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
You got the motivation of Reed going back to Philly.
Yeah.
You got a whole new thing there. And you're talking different conferences. You're talking NFC and AFC.
Yeah.
And when you see these NFC-AFC matchups early in the year, they can be surprising.
Yeah.
You know, the Chargers went into Philly and won.
Yeah.
You know, so I see the AFC being historically pretty awesome. The NFC right now, there's some good teams there, but there's still good football in the AFC. When they come out to play, anything goes down.
Yeah, and I was shocked by the turnovers on the punting game, the interceptions by Vic. I was really kind of disappointed. The defense had a little bit of a problem slowing down Kansas City too, but I was surprised. Eagles had 5 turnovers in that game. You're not beating anybody with 5
turnovers.
Well,
that's the biggest problem. And even then, it's still only a 10-point game.
So yeah, exactly. So that's the thing. And the two drives that the Eagles actually put together, good touchdown scoring drives, it was like a 3-play drive then a 5-play drive.
Right, exactly.
It was just boom, boom, boom.
Yeah.
So.
Bengals.
Bengals?
Dude, I'm a Steeler fan. I'm literally just waving the white flag of surrender.
Yeah.
Bengals are the best team in the AFC North.
They look strong, man. They had 4 turnovers, or both teams had 4 turnovers in the game, but they come back in the fourth quarter and upset the Pack. Man.
They got a steady quarterback to control the ball.
I never thought coming out of TCU, Dalton was going to be that reliable.
But they got great receivers.
They do.
They have the two good tight ends.
Yeah.
Just like New England had the last couple years.
Yep.
Since he's got them now.
Yeah.
They got two tight ends. They run the same two tight end formations, and they are killing people with it.
Yeah.
And then they get the running back out of the draft. They get the other running back that they've had.
Yeah, they have like Ben Jarvis, Green, Ellis.
The law firm.
And then they have the first pick out of the draft this year
Giovanni
from North Carolina.
Bernard.
Yeah.
And Giovanni Bernard looks good. So you have the law firm and you have the rookie.
The law firm, I think that.
Ben Jarvis, Green, Ellis. Dude, I mean, so the law firm is good enough as well. And then you have the other one.
Yeah.
Cowboys crushing the Rams.
Yeah, surprising.
What the hell is the deal with the Rams?
Yeah, I don't know. I thought at some point they were going to kick a, you know, take a spark and get on fire, but
brutal. Man,
yeah.
Titans.
Yeah, beating the Chargers. Locker is looking like he's gonna be there to stay in Tennessee. I heard some people talking about they weren't real sure if he was gonna be around there for
very
long.
A little rain coming in. We're good.
Yeah, we're good.
Browns
over the Vikings.
Surprising of the weekend.
Yeah, after letting go of Trent Richardson too, and they go into Minnesota. Who's 0-3 now, which is pretty surprising.
And now you're going to have Minnesota go to London to play Pittsburgh, and both teams are 0-3.
Yeah.
That'll be good.
Yeah, and they had they didn't even have Whedon. They had Hoyer, their backup, who threw for 321 on them. So.
Money. Yep. Pats crushed.
Crushed. Saints
crushed. Lions beat the Skins.
Yeah,
Skins are hurting.
Yeah, they're hurting bad, man.
Panthers over the Giants crushing.
Yeah, 0-3 the Giants now.
Brutal.
Yep.
Okay, Ravens beat the Texans, and that was surprising as hell.
Yeah, me too. I thought
Texans didn't show up at all.
Yeah, I agree.
Dolphins.
3-0, beat the
Falcons.
Great
game. Game of the week to watch.
Yeah, Tannehill,
dude,
man.
That was the best game of the weekend.
Yep.
Jets-Bills was the other great game of the weekend.
Yeah, Emmanuel and Smith going back and forth.
Colts beat the Niners. Who saw that one coming?
Yeah.
Trent Richardson goes to the Colts, and Richardson's money.
Yeah, I still don't get that trade, but.
Okay, Seahawks, we already know that was going to happen. And then, of course, Steelers. Bull crap.
Yeah, and Roethlisberger threw for like 406 yards, too, so you can't expect much more out of him.
No. And then Bo's been watching the America's Cup.
Oh, it's dope, man. The U.S. was
boat
down.
Racing.
Yeah, yachting, sailing. Yeah, they were down eight races to one against New Zealand, sponsored by Fly Emirates. U.S. is sponsored by Oracle. They come back, win 7 straight, tie it up. They got the game, the deciding race tomorrow in San Francisco Bay. It's going to be awesome.
It's the equivalent of the Red Sox-Yankee comeback.
Yeah, I mean, it's huge. They won, yeah. They got
8-1
yeah,
and
they
come back to win.
Yeah, and they had already been penalized 2 points for some sort of infraction earlier in the year. So, technically, they should have won.
Oh, already.
But they had two,
they had that
two
point
taken away.
With.
Yeah, so.
All right, people, let's get this top 5 real quick with this rain happening here.
Yeah.
Top 5 rules for a bye week. Your first rule is, number 5 is, get some yard work done.
Yeah, because you know it's going to be raining like this all the time.
Yeah.
So you get it in
you
while you get
that
it
while
in.
You can, exactly. Number 4, you got to watch a different league, a different sport, like the America's Cup. You got to watch a different something.
Yeah.
Okay, don't just go to like whatever the next football game is.
Yeah.
Number 3, you got to leave the house. Okay, just go do something. Go to the park. Go do something.
Yeah.
Not be creepy way or anything.
Yeah.
Number 2, you got to take time off. So they're taking time off. They're not practicing. You take time off.
Yeah.
You don't practice.
Yeah.
You don't watch anything.
Unplug.
Unplug.
Yeah.
Relax.
Yep.
Okay, and number 1, cannot lose on the bye week. Don't lose. Okay, so don't get hurt. Don't get injured.
Yeah, don't
you
get
personally,
don't
get in trouble. Don't
get
jail.
Arrested. Yeah.
Exactly. All right, people, we survived this little rainstorm. It's simple here. Sports Chat 503. I will be at the Cal game. I'll give you the footage. Check out for that Cal footage next week, and then we'll get the recap after this. We're doing this on Monday or Tuesday, people.
Yep.
We're doing this. Yeah. Sports Chat 503, people.
All right, be good.
Adios.